Hi, welcome back. It's Nick here again from Exam.net, and I'm going to show you a video today on how to manage your exam list, since it can get very long over time and be hard to find specific exams. Before we get going, I want to show you the Profile tab. In this tab, you can change your login details and other settings. But the very last option at the bottom is Show Recently Deleted Data. This is where you can recover an exam if you accidentally deleted it. I'll refer to this again later in the video. Now let's click on Exam Lists. And here's the screen you see when you log in to exam.net. This list can get quite long, as you can see mine has here. So let's take a look at how you can manage and get some order into your exam list. Firstly, you can search for a specific exam by clicking on the magnifying glass icon here and entering the name of the exam. Typing Ctrl F or Command F if you are a Mac user is a shortcut to this search option. You can also sort exams by name or the date when you made the exam by clicking on those column headings. The sort indicator is shown for that column. Now let's talk about organising your exams. One way is to tag exams with a specific colour. Decide which exam you want to assign a colour to and click on the three dots furthest to the right, which brings up this menu. If you choose Tag Exam with a Colour, this will allow you to assign a colour to an exam and that colour will show up like this to the left of the exam. I usually use one colour to highlight exams that need to be marked and another colour for those where I have completed marking. But you can use the colours as you like, of course. You might like to distinguish between quizzes, tests, and longer exams, for example. Another way to organise exams is by creating groups. You've probably noticed this button, Create New Group, below your exam list. Clicking on it allows you to enter a name and choose a colour. Okay, so I've created a group, and now let's click on the icon with the three dots again next to one of my exams. You can now choose to move this exam into a group like this. Now you can see that this exam has been moved into that group. I usually use this to organise my exams into the classes I teach. If you create multiple groups, as I've done, you can reorder them using these icons on the bar here. You can also click the settings icon to edit or delete the group. Note that deleting a group does not delete the exams in that group. Let's go over the other options in this menu. Okay, so selecting Delete the Exam will delete the exam and all the student answers. The exam ends up in the trash can, or dustbin in my case. It can be retrieved for the following 20 days under the Profile tab, as I mentioned at the beginning of this video. If you want to remove an exam from your list, it's useful to choose Archive the Exam. This removes it from your list, but you can still access it by scrolling to the bottom of the window and clicking on Show Archive. It's important to know that all exams are automatically archived 180 days after they're created and will remain in the archive for 3 years. Exams are not visible after 3 years in accordance with our privacy policy. If an exam is soon to be automatically archived, you'll see a green warning pop up like this. There's one other aspect regarding archiving exams that I want to explain. Let's scroll down to the bottom of our window and select Show Archive. If you want to move an exam out of your archive and back to your main exam list, you click the three dots next to that exam, and in this menu you can select Delete Answers and Unarchive. Note that once an exam has been archived or deleted, it's not possible to retrieve the student data in accordance with our privacy policy. Now, let's go over the last three items in this menu. Duplicate the exam will create a copy of the exam with identical settings and content. Everything except for student data and shared access settings will be copied. This new exam will be ready to use straight away. All you have to do is give the exam a new name and click Create. Then it will end up at the top of your exam list. Send individual resume exam keys via email is a really helpful feature if you're conducting an exam over several sessions. Since students don't have accounts with exam.net, there is no way for students to get back into an exam they've already started. This feature allows you to automatically send a special individual exam key to each student via email, which allows them to get back into their specific exam and continue working on it. Note that this requires that you set up the exam so that they enter their email addresses when starting it. The next option in the menu is Give Another Teacher Access, which allows you to share an exam with another teacher. You'll see a list of teachers that have registered with Exam.net at your school. Just select Access next to their name in order to share it with them. For shared exams, a People icon will be added to the Status column like this. Sharing exams is helpful if you're running the same exam for several classes with different teachers, or if someone other than yourself is supervising the exam for you. You can even share an exam for use at a later date. Sometimes you might want a chosen action to affect several exams at the same time, for example, opening or sharing multiple exams. You can do that by first selecting the checkbox next to each exam and then selecting the appropriate icon in the exam list toolbar. Let's finish off this video by explaining a couple of the columns in the exam list. In your exam list, you see the exam key for each exam. Clicking the exam key takes you to an exam preview. When you move your mouse over the exam key, it also gives you the option to copy the exam key or present it in larger text. The shield icon and the status column indicates the security mode that you selected when creating that exam. The access column shows you whether each exam is open, closed, or discoverable. And the buttons to the right allow you to edit, monitor, and preview the exam. Thanks for watching this video, and if you have a colleague interested in using exam.net, it's really easy to invite them to try it out. Just click on the My School tab and find the section Invite Colleague. Clicking this button will copy a link that you can email to your colleagues. It leads to a shortcut enabling them to create an account at your school. Bye for now, and I'll see you in the next video.